Bonjour, we're continuing our series about questions, but this time using quel. Quel is the only one that acts as an adjective, meaning that it works with a noun, and because of that, we need to do the agreement with a noun. Let's take a look. Okay, some very simple question that you have to use every day. Quel âge as-tu? How old are you? Quel âge? Âge is masculine, so we will have the masculine form. Quelle est ta nationalité? What is your nationality? Nationality is feminine, donc quelle feminine form? Pareil for date de naissance, same thing for date de naissance, your birth date, feminine and singular. Quel est ton numéro? That would be masculine, feminine for address. Oh, but why do we use ton? Remember, we have a vowel sound, so we need to use a masculine form for the liaison. Ta adresse wouldn't work, donc ton adresse. And we cannot do T apostrophe because that's what we use for reflexive verbs, right? Quels sont tes passe-temps? Un passe-temps, we know because there's no E, so we know that it is masculine. Okay, so masculin, pluriel. Et quelles sont les activités? Activities is féminin, donc quel féminin pluriel? Let's look at more how we transform these questions that are very informal because we use the form tu, and we will use the form vous. Okay, so let's just transform them as a practice. Quel âge as-tu? Quel âge avez-vous? Quelle est ta nationalité? Quelle est votre nationalité? Quelle est votre date de naissance? Quel est votre numéro? Quelle est votre adresse? Quels sont vos passe-temps? Quelles sont les activités que vous n'aimez pas? In all these questions in English, it would transfer by you, right? How old are you? It can be the tu form or the vous form. We don't see the difference. Something else that we need to notice, because quel is an adjective and it goes with a noun, we need to use the inversion with it. Quel âge as-tu? Okay, quelle est ta nationalité? So instead of having the subject and the verb, we will have the verb and the subject. That's it for today. Bonne journée.